last song we just sang, Pete Pete, is a song from Ghana. And it relates the experience of a child who has spent too much time playing with his friends instead of helping with dinner preparations inside the house. When the meal is ready, the mother calls for the child to come in using the nickname Pete, which translated means vulture. She uses a particular word in jest to describe the voraciousness of the child's appetite. So I thought that was kind of appropriate for middle school kids.
Holocaust is a stunning reminder of the tragic results of prejudice and hate for other people. But it is also a reminder that hope of firm will eventually reign victorious on the greatest of all. The following words were inscribed on the walls of the cellar of Cologne, Germany, where Jews were hiding from the Nazis during World War II. Hope was all they had to hold on to. Hope was their only bridge to a brighter tomorrow.
Thank you.
But they do not sound like a typical middle school choir. They really have a beautiful sound. The baritone section, even though they can drive me nuts, they have a wonderful, wonderful sound, and all of them have a really, really good work ethic. They worked so hard this last 9 weeks. As Mr. Haas said, I was only with them every other week, so I made rehearsal recordings for them, uploaded them onto Canvas on their iPads, and so the week I wasn't there, and Mrs. Gabert worked with them, and they worked a lot on their own with the rehearsal recordings, so they need to be very, very proud of what they've accomplished too. This is I am proud of them. We had a slight change in the program. We were going to flip-flop our last two songs. How Can I Keep From Singing has three small groups that I want to recognize. And the first group is Anna Furrow, Bella Riffle, and Katie Cox. The second group is Katie Stewart and Emily Baugh. And in the third group, we have our sopranos, Reagan Becker, Kara Grimes, Nikki Broyles, and Nicholas Kravitz. So this is How Can I Keep From Singing.
Music get together every few weeks, and so we got together in December, and Mrs. McMillan said, I'm thinking about doing two jobs next semester, because here's a shocker, nobody wanted to come and teach choir for one semester. So she said, am I crazy? And we said, yes, that's probably not a great idea, but she didn't care, she did it anyway. So what she's done since January is Circle of the State and Honor Choir, Solo and Ensemble District and State, a concert with the third graders, this concert, a high school festival Tuesday night. She has another middle school concert, another high school concert, a third grade concert, graduation and baccalaureate. And why did she do that? Because she's crazy, but she actually did it for your kids. When we said, Mrs. McKee said, Lisa, that is so much work, and she said, but I don't want the kids to be cheated out of the semester of music. I want them to have a good experience and finish the year. So while she was with the middle school kids, she has made lesson plans for the Riddle kids. And when she's with the Riddle kids, she has made lesson plans for the middle school and high school kids. So she really has done two jobs for 9 weeks, and she's only halfway done. So please recognize her for her extra work.
Thank you. more time for our governor, Mrs. Gallagher. And one more time for our students, Mrs. Gallagher. And now, Mrs. Gallagher's in the crowd, will you stand up, please? I'd like to thank her, she's been our... And of course, Mrs. McMillan doing all the extra work here at RCSC, we really appreciate it. Thank you for attending. Please take time to take pictures and everything you want to do out there in the entryway there. The students exit up the back and come around. Thank you again.